Wonderful coffee. Meal in itself.
Can I make you some eggs?
Nah, take a breath.
You look so rested, dear.
I slept like a dead one. First time in months. Imagine sleeping till 10 o'clock on a Tuesday morning. The boys leave nice and early, huh?
They were out of here by 8 o'clock.
Good work.
It was so thrilling to see them leaving together. I can't get over the shaving lotion in this house. Biff was very changed this morning, Willie. His whole attitude seemed to be hopeful. He couldn't wait to get downtown to see Oliver.
He's heading for a change. There's no question. There simply are certain men who take longer to get solidified. How'd he dress?
His blue suit. He's so handsome in that suit. He could be anything in that suit.
There's no question. No question at all. Gee, on the way home tonight, I'd like to buy some seeds.
Be wonderful. Not enough sun gets back there.
You wait, kid. When this is all over, I'll get ourselves a little place out in the country and we'll raise some vegetables, a couple of chickens.
You'll do it yet,
and they'll get married and come for the weekend. I could build a guest house because I got so many fine tools. All I would need is some peace of mind and a little lumber.
I saw the lining on your jacket.
I could build two guest houses so they'd both come. Did Biff say how much he was going to ask Oliver for?
He didn't mention, but I imagine 10 or 15,000. You going to talk to Howard today?
Yeah. I'll lay it out to him flat and simple. He'll just have to take me off the road.
And don't forget to ask for a little advance, because we've got the insurance premium. It's the grace period now.
That's 100 and...
108.68, because we're a little short again.
Why are we short?
Well, you had the motor job done in the car.
Goddamn Studebaker.
Well, you've only got one more payment on the refrigerator.
But it just broke again.
Well, it's old, dear.
I told you we should have bought a well-advertised machine. Charlie bought a General Electric, and it's 20 years old, and it's still good, that son of a bitch.
But Willie...
Who ever heard of a Hastings refrigerator? Once in my life, I would like to own something outright before it's broken. I'm always in a race with the junkyard. Why, we just finished paying for that car. It's on its last legs. The refrigerator consumes belts like a goddamn maniac. They time those things. They time them so that when they're finally used up, it's over. Come on.
Well, all told, about $200 would carry us. But that includes the last payment on the mortgage, really. After this, the house belongs to us.
25 years.
It was 9 years old when we bought it.
Well, that's a great thing, too. Whether a 25-year mortgage is...
It's an accomplishment.
All the lumber, the cement, the reconstruction I put into this house. There ain't a crack to be found in it anymore.
Well, it served its purpose.
What purpose? Someone will come along and move in, and that's that. Only Biff were to take the house and start a family. I'll be home early. It's late.
Oh, I forgot. You're supposed to meet them for dinner.
Me?
At Frank's Chop House, on 48th near 6th Avenue.
Don't say. Well, what about you?
No, just three of you. They're going to blow you to a big meal.
That's so. Well, who thought of that?
Biff came to me this morning, Willie, and he said, tell Dad we're going to blow him to a big meal. Be there at 6. You and your boys are going to have dinner.
Gee whiz, that's really something. I'm going to knock Howard for a loop today, kid. I'll come home with an advance, and I'll get a New York job. God damn it! Now I'm gonna do it!
That's the spirit, Willie.
I'll never get behind the wheel of a car for the rest of my life.
It's changing, Willie. I can feel it changing.
Beyond a question. Well, goodbye. It's late.
You got your glasses?
Yeah, I got my glasses.
And your handkerchief?
And my handkerchief.
And your saffron.
And my saffron.
Be careful on the subway stairs.
Will you stop mending stockings? At least one in the house. It gets me nervous. I can't tell you.
Remember, please? Frank's Chop House.
Maybe beets would grow outside.
You've tried so many times.
Yeah, well, don't work hard today.
Careful. Just a minute. In a minute. Hello? Oh, Biff, I'm so glad you called. Yes, I just told him. Yes, we'll be there for dinner at 6 o'clock. I didn't forget. Listen, I was just dying to tell you. You know that little rubber pipe I told you about? That he connected to the gas heater? Well, I finally decided to go down to the cellar this morning, take it away and destroy it. But it's gone. Imagine it isn't there. When? Oh, then you took it. Oh, nothing. I just hoped he'd taken it away himself, that's all. Oh, no. I'm not worried, darling. Because this morning he left in such high spirits. It was like the old days. You seen Oliver yet? Well, you wait there then and make a nice impression on him. Just don't perspire too much before you see him. And have a nice time with Dad. He may have big news too. That's right, a New York job. And be sweet to him tonight, dear. Be loving to him. Because he's only a little boat looking for a harbor. Well, that's wonderful, dear. You'll save his life. Thanks, darling. Just put your arm around him when he comes to the restaurant. Give him a smile. That's the boy. That's fine. Bye, Biff, dear.
Howard, can I talk to you for a minute?
Come in, Willie. Sorry to keep you waiting.
I'd like to ask you a little favor, Howard.
Oh, sure. 2 minutes. Ever see one of these before? Most terrific machine I've ever seen in my life. I was up all night with it.
Listen, Howard.
I just got delivery last night. It's been driving me crazy.
Well, what is it?
Wire recorder.
Well, what do you do with it?
Well, I bought it for dictation, but you can do anything with it. Listen to this. I had it on last night. Listen to what I picked one. The first one is my daughter. Get this. Listen to that kid whistle.
That is lifelike, isn't it?
7 years old.
Now
get
you,
that
Daddy.
Tone. Oh, she's crazy for me.
You're very good.
That's me.
Well, that certainly is.
Shh, shh. Get this now. Next one is my son.
The capital of Alabama is Montgomery. The capital of Arizona is Phoenix. The capital of Arkansas is Little Rock.
5 years old,
the capital
really?
Of California is
He'll
Sacramento.
He'll make an announcer someday.
Get that. Alphabetical order. Wait a minute. The maid kicked the plug out.
That really is a...
Shh, for God's sake.
It's 9 o'clock, below the watch time. So I have to go to sleep.
That certainly is.
Wait a minute. The next one is my wife.
Go on, say something. Well, you gonna talk?
I can't think of anything.
Well, talk. It's turning.
That was my wife.
This really is a remarkable machine.
I tell you, Willie, I'm gonna take my camera, my bandsaw, and all my hobbies, and out they go. This is the most fascinating relaxation I've ever found.
I think I'll get one for myself.
Sure, they're only 100 and a half. You can't do without it. Supposing you want to hear Jack Benny, see? But you can't be home at that hour. So you tell the maid to turn the radio on when Jack Benny comes on, and this automatically goes on with the radio.
And when you get home,
you can come home at 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, anytime you like. Grab yourself a Coke, sit yourself down, throw the switch, and there's Jack Benny's program in the middle of the night.
I'll certainly get one for myself, because so many times I think when I'm on the road that, what, it must be missing on the radio.
Don't you have a radio in the car?
Well, yeah, but whoever thinks of turning it on?
Say, aren't you supposed to be in Boston?
That's what I'd like to talk to you about, Howard.
What happened? What are you doing here? You
got a minute?
Ah, jeez. You didn't crack up again, did you?
No.
Oh, good. You got me worried there for a minute. What's the trouble?
Well, to tell you the truth, Howard, I've come to the decision that I'd rather not travel anymore.
Not travel? Well, what will you do?
Well, remember Christmas time when you had the party here? You said you'd try to find a spot for me here in town.
With us?
Well, sure.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember. I couldn't find anything for you, Willie.
Listen, Howard, I don't need much anymore. The kids are all grown up, you know. With $65 a week, I could swing it.
Yeah, but Willie, see...
Listen, Howard, speaking frankly and between the two of us, I'm just a little bit tired.
Oh, I can get that, Willie. But you're a road man, Willie, and we do a road business. We only have half a dozen salesmen on the floor here.
God knows, Howard. I've never asked a favor of any man, but your father came to me the day you were born.
Oh, I know that, Willie.
And father, your father, when he came to me, he asked me what I thought of the name Howard on the day you were born.
I appreciate that, Willie, and if I had a spot, I'd slam you right in. But I just don't have a single solitary spot.
Listen, Howard, all I need to set my table is $50 a week. That's it.
But where am I going to put you?
Listen, it's not a question of whether or not I can sell merchandise, is it?
No, but it's a business, kid, and everyone has to pull his own weight.
Listen, Howard, just let me tell you
because
a story.
Because you have to admit, business is business.
Oh, business is definitely business, but you gotta listen for a minute. You don't understand. When I was a boy, 18, 19, I was already on the road, and there was a question in my mind as to whether selling had a future for me. Because in those days, I had a yearning to go to Alaska. See, there were 3 gold strikes in 1 month in Alaska, and I felt like going out. Just for the ride, you might say.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah. My father lived many years in Alaska. He was an adventurous man. We've got quite a little streak of self-reliance in our family. I thought I'd go out with my older brother and try to locate, and maybe settle in the north with the old man. And I almost decided to go when I met a salesman in the Parker House. His name was Dave Singleman, and he was 84 years old, and he drummed merchandise in 31 states. And old Dave, he'd go up to his room, you understand, and put on his green velvet slippers, I'll never forget it, pick up the phone and call the buyers. And without ever leaving his room at the age of 84, he made his living. And when I saw that, I realized that selling was the single greatest career a man could want. Because what could be more satisfying than to be able to go out at the age of 84 in 20 or 30 different cities and pick up the phone and be remembered and loved and helped by so many different people? Did you know when he died, and by the way, he died the death of a salesman, in his green velvet slippers on the smoker of the New York, New Haven, and Hartford going into Boston. When he died, hundreds of salesmen and buyers were at his funeral. Things were sad on a lot of trains for months after that. You see what I mean, Howard? In those days, there was personality in it. There was respect and comradeship. Today, it's all cut and dried, and there's no chance of bringing friendship to bear or personality. You see what I mean, Howard? They don't know me anymore.
That's just the thing, Willie.
Listen, Howard, all I need is $40. That's all I would need.
Kid, I can't take blood from a stone.
Howard, the year Al Smith was nominated, your father came to me.
Kid, I've got to go see some people.
Howard, I'm talking about your father. He wants to tell me you've got people to see. I put 34 years into this firm, Howard, and now I can't pay my insurance. If you can't eat an orange and throw the peel away, a man is not a piece of fruit. Now pay attention. Your father... In 1928, I had a very big year. I averaged 107...
Willie, you Howard, never averaged.
Howard, in the year of 1928, I averaged $170 a week. And your father came to me... It was right here in this office. It was right across this desk. And he came to me and put his hand on my shoulder.
Kid, I've got to go see some people. Pull yourself together.
Pull myself together? What the hell did I say to him? My God, I was yelling at him. Frank, don't you remember when I opened up the 3 new Portland accounts and you congratulated me long distance? And Frank, you put your hand on my shoulder. Frank!
The capital of Alabama is Montgomery. The capital Howard! Of Arizona is Phoenix.
Howard! Get out of here, Howard!
Is Little Rock. The capital of California is Sacramento.
What happened?
Shut
the
it off.
Colorado
Shut it off.
Denver. The capital of...
Look, Willie.
I gotta get some coffee. I'll get some coffee.
Willie, look.
I'll go to Boston.
You can't go to Boston for us.
Why can't I go?
I don't want you to represent us. I've been meaning to tell you this for a long time.
Howard, are you firing me?
I think you need a good long rest, Willie.
Howard.
And when you feel better, come back and we'll see if we can work something out.
But Howard, I gotta earn money. I'm in no position.
Where are your sons? Why don't your sons give you a hand?
Well, they're working on a very big deal, Howard.
This is no time for false pride, Willie. You go to your sons and tell them you're tired. You've got 2 great boys, haven't you?
Oh, no question. No question at all. But in the meantime...
Then that's that.
All right. I'll go to Boston.
No.
Howard,
no.
I can't throw myself at my sons. I'm not a cripple.
Look, kid, I've got people to see.
Howard, you've got to let me go to Boston.
I've got a line of people to see me this morning. So, do me a favor. Take 5 minutes. Pull yourself together. And then go home, will you? I need the office. Oh, yeah. Whenever you can this week, stop by and drop off the samples. You'll feel better, and then we'll talk. Pull yourself together, kid. There's people outside.
Ben, how did you do it? What's the answer? Did you wind up the Alaska deal so quickly?
Doesn't take much time if you know what you're doing.
Ben, I've
got... Just a short business trip. Boarding a ship in an hour. Wanted to say goodbye.
Ben, nothing's working out. I don't know what to do.
Now look here, William. I've just bought timberland in Alaska. I needed a man to look after things for me.
God, timberland. Me and my boys in those grand outdoors.
You've a new continent at your doorstep, William. Get out of these cities. They're full of talk and time payments and courts of law. Screw in your fists and you can fight for a fortune up there.
Yes. Yes! Linda! Linda!
But I don't have much time.
No, wait.
Oh. You're back.
Linda, he's got a proposition for me in Alaska.
But you've got... He's got a beautiful job here.
But Alaska, kid,
you're doing well enough, Willie.
Enough for what, my dear?
Don't say those things to him. Enough to be happy right here, right now. Why must everybody conquer the world? You're well-liked. Boys love you and wife. Just the other day, old Frank Wagner said that if he keeps it up, he'll be a member of the firm, didn't he, Willie?
It's true, man. It's true. And if I am building something with this firm, and if a man is building something, he must be on the right track. Mustn't he?
What are you building? Lay your hand on it. Where is it?
He's right, Linda. There's nothing.
Why, there's a man 84 years old.
That's right, Ben, that's right. When I see that man, I say, what is there to worry about?
Ah!
It's true, Ben, it's true. All he has to do is go into any store and pick up the phone and he's making his living.
I have to go.
Ben, why am I wrong? Look at this boy. Without a penny to his name, three great universities are begging for him. And from there, the sky's the limit. Because it's not what you do, Ben. It's who you know. And the smile on your face. It's contacts, Ben. Contacts. The whole wealth of Alaska passes over the Commodore Hotel at lunchtime. And that's the beauty of this country, that a man can end with diamonds on the basis of being liked. And that's why, when you go out into the field today, it's important. Because thousands of people will be rooting for you and loving you. And Ben, when he walks into a business office, his name will sound out like a bell. I've seen it, Ben. I've seen it 1,000 times. You can't lay your hand in it like timber, but it's there.
Goodbye, William.
No, wait. Ben, am I right? Please tell me I'm right.
You have a whole continent at your doorstep, William. You could walk out rich.
Oh, Ben, we're gonna do it here, you hear me? We're gonna do it here!
Oh, gee, I was afraid you left already.
Why? What time is it?
It's 1:30.
Well, everybody in the car, next stop, Ebbets Field. Where's the pennants?
Did you pack fresh underwear?
I got everything. I'm ready to go.
Hey, Biff, I'm carrying your helmet, ain't I?
I'm carrying the helmet.
Biff, you promised me.
I'm carrying
the helmet. How am I going to get to the locker room?
Let him carry the shoulder guards.
Can I, Biff? Because I told everybody I'm going to be in the locker room.
In Ebbets Field, it's the clubhouse.
I meant the clubhouse, Biff.
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 Biff. Let him carry the shoulder guards. Stay close to us now.
Everybody wave when Biff comes out of the field. You ready now, boy?
Ready to go, Pop. Every muscle is ready.
Realize what this means.
That's right, Pop.
You're coming home today, the captain of the All-Scholastic Championship team of the city of New York.
That's right, Pop. And remember, when I take off my helmet, that play's gonna be for you.
Well, let's get out of here. I got no room for you, Charlie.
Room for what?
In the car.
The car? You going for a ride? I wanted to shoot some casino.
Casino? Don't you realize what today is?
He knows, Willie. He's just kidding you.
That's nothing to kid about.
No, Linda, what's going on?
He's playing it up his field.
Baseball in this weather.
Come on, everyone. We don't want to be late.
No, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Didn't you hear the news?
What?
Don't you listen to the radio. Ebbets Field. Just what?
Oh, you go to hell, will you? Just go to hell. Come on, everyone. We don't want to be late.
Knock a homer, Biff. Knock a homer.
That wasn't very funny, Charlie. This is the greatest day of his life.
Willie, when are you going to grow up?
When this game is over, Charlie, you'll be laughing out of the other side of your goddamn face. They'll be calling him another Red Grange, $25,000 a year.
Is that so?
Yeah, that's so.
Well then, Willie, I'm sorry. Why don't you tell me something?
What?
Who is Red Grange?
Put up your hands, goddamn you! Put up your hands! Who the hell do you think you are, better than everybody else? You don't know everything, you big, ignorant, stupid...
Say, Bernard, will you go out in the hall?
Don't walk away.
What is that noise? Who is it?
It's Mr. Lohman. He just got off the elevator.
But you'll be laughing out of the other side of your goddamn face.
Nobody?
When this game is over.
There's nobody with him.
Touchdown.
I just can't deal with him anymore.
Touchdown.
And your father gets all upset every time he comes.
He's at the 30. He's at
I've got
40.
A lot 50. Of typing to do,
60.
And
70.
Your father's waiting to sign it.
Touchdown.
Will you see him?
Are they going to get the extra point?
Sure, I'll see him.
Jenny. Jenny, how are you? Honest or still work?
Fine.
Hello, Uncle Willie.
Oh, Bernard, look who's here.
How are you?
What are you doing
Good
here?
To see you. Just stop by to see Pop. Get off my feet till my train leaves.
Is he in?
Yes, he's in with the accountant. Sit down.
Well, what are you going to be doing in Washington?
Well, just in case I've got there, Willie.
That's so. You going to be playing tennis while you're there?
Staying with a friend who has a court.
That's so. His own private tennis court. Must be fine people, I bet.
Oh, they are very, very nice. Dad tells me Biff is in town.
Yeah, Biff's in. Working on a very big deal, Bernard.
What's he doing?
Well, Biff's been doing very big things in the West, but he decided to establish himself here. Very big. Did I hear your wife had a boy?
That's right, our second.
Two boys? Well, what do you know?
Still at the old firm, Willie?
I'm overjoyed to see how you made the grade, Bernard. Overjoyed. It's a refreshing thing to see a young boy make it. Really. Looks very good for Biff, you know. Very. Bernard?
What is it, Willie?
What's the secret?
What secret?
Why didn't Biff ever catch on?
I wouldn't know that, Willie.
But you were his friend, his childhood friend. There's something there that I don't understand. His life ended after that Ebbets Field game. From the age of 17, nothing good ever happened to him.
He never trained himself for anything.
But he did. He did. After high school, he took so many correspondence courses, radio mechanics, television, and never made the slightest mark.
Willie, do you want to talk candidly?
I value your advice, Bernard. I regard you as a very brilliant man.
What the hell with advice, Willie? I couldn't advise you. Just one thing I've always wanted to know. When he was supposed to graduate, and the math teacher flunked him.
That son of a bitch ruined
really,
his
all
life.
He had to do was go to summer school and make up the subject.
That's right. That's right.
Did you tell him not to go?
Me? I ordered him to go.
Then why wouldn't he go?
Why? Why? Bernard, that question has been trailing me like a ghost for the last 15 years. He flunked the subject and laid down and died like a hammerhead.
Take it easy, kid.
Bernard, let me talk to you. I got nobody to talk to, Bernard. You see, it keeps going around in my head. Maybe I did something to him. I've got nothing to give him, Bernard. See?
Don't take it so hard.
Bernard, was it my fault?
Willie, I remember it was June and our grades came out.
That son of a bitch.
It wasn't right then. He was ready to enroll in summer school.
He was?
He wasn't beaten by it at all. Then, Willie, he disappeared from the block for almost a month. And I got the idea that... Did he go up to New England to see you? Willie.
Yeah, he came to Boston. What about it?
Well, it's just that when he came back... Never forget, this always mystifies me. Because I thought so well of Biff, even though he'd always taken advantage of me. I loved him, Willie, you know? He came back after that month. With his sneakers, remember? The ones with University of Virginia printed on them? So proud of those, he wore them every day. He took his sneakers down in the cellar. And burned them in the furnace. We had a fist fight. It lasted at least half an hour, just the two of us punching each other and crying right through it. What happened in Boston, Willie? I only ask because you mentioned it.
Nothing. Nothing happened. What has that got to do with anything?
Well, don't get sore.
Well, what, are you trying to blame it on me? If a boy's laid down, that's my fault?
Now, Willie, don't...
Well, don't talk to me that way, Bernard. Now, what does that mean? What happened?
You're going to miss your train.
Yeah, I'm going. Thanks, Pop. Goodbye, Willie, and remember, if at first you don't succeed...
Yes, I believe in you.
But, Willie, sometimes it's better for a man to just walk away.
Walk away?
That's right.
Well, what if a man can't just walk away?
I guess that's when it's tough. Goodbye, Willie.
Goodbye, boy.
How do you like this kid? He's gonna argue a case in front of the Supreme Court.
The Supreme Court?
I gotta run. Bye, Dad.
But knock him dead, Bernard.
Supreme Court. And he didn't even mention it.
Oh, he don't have to. He's gonna do it.
You never told him what to do, did you? You never took any interest in him.
Oh, Willie, my salvation is I never took any interest in anything. No. Here's $50 for the week. I got an accountant inside.
Listen, Charlie, if you can manage it, I need $110 by the end of the month. I have my insurance to pay, Charlie, and I draw it from my own bank, but then Linda would know.
Willie, why don't you sit down?
I promise, I'm keeping strict accounts.
Now, Willie.
I appreciate everything, Charlie.
Listen, Willie.
Listen, I appreciate...
Willie, what are you doing? What the hell is going on in your head?
Why, I'm simply...
Willie, I offered you a job. You can make $50 a week here, and I won't send you on the road.
Got a job.
Without pay. Now, what kind of job is a job without pay? Now, look, kid. I'm no genius, but I know when I'm being insulted.
Insulted?
Why don't you want to work for me?
What's the matter with you? I've got a job.
And what do you keep walking in here for?
Well, if you don't want me to come in here anymore...
I am offering you a job.
I don't want your goddamn job!
When the hell are you going to grow up?
I don't care how big you get, Charlie. I'll still wrap you one.
How much? How much do you need, Willie?
Strap, Charlie. I'm strapped. Howard fired me today.
Howard fired you?
A little snot nose. Imagine that. I named him. I named him Howard.
Willie, you named him Howard, but you can't sell that. The only thing you've got in this world is what you can sell. The funny thing is that you're a salesman and you don't know that.
I guess I've always liked to think otherwise. Always thought that the man was impressive and well-liked.
And why must everyone like you? Who liked J.P. Morgan? Was he impressive? In a Turkish bath, he looked like a butcher. But with his pockets on, he was very well-liked. Now look, kid. I know you don't like me. And no one can say I'm in love with you, but I'll give you a job because... just for the hell of it. Put it that way. Now what do you say?
I just can't work for you, Charlie.
What are you? You jealous of me?
I just can't take your job. Don't ask me why.
No. No, you've been jealous of me all your life, you damned fool. Pay your insurance.
I keep being strict accounts.
Take care of yourself, Willie. Pay your insurance.
You know what's funny? After all the highways and the trains and the appointments and the years, you end up being worth more dead than alive.
Now, Willie, nobody's worth nothing dead. You heard what I said, didn't you? Willie!
Apologize to Bernard for me, will you? I didn't mean to argue with him. He's a fine boy. They're all fine boys, and they'll all end up big. One day they'll be playing tennis together. Wish me luck, Charlie. You saw Bill Oliver today.
Good luck.
You know, you're the only friend I got, Charlie. Isn't that a remarkable thing?
Jesus.
Well, that's all right, Mr. Lohman. I need all that myself.
This is better.
Well, Sean, up front there, in the middle of all kinds of noise. When do we got party, Mr. Lohman? Just tell me. Put you back here. You know, there's a lot of people. They're like a private. When they go out, like to see a lot of action because they're sick and tired to stay in the house by themselves. I know you, Mr. Loman. You ain't from Hackensack.
So how's it coming, Stanley?
Oh, it's a dog's life. Almost during the war, took me in the army. Coming dead by now.
My brother's back, Stanley.
Oh, he come back from the far west.
Yeah, big cattleman, my brother. So treat him right. And my father's coming, too.
Oh, your father, too.
Got a couple nice lobsters?
100% big.
I want them with the claws.
Don't worry, Mr. Loman. I don't give you no mice. Hey, how about some wine? I'll put a head on the meal.
You remember, Stanley, that recipe I brought you from overseas? With the champagne in it.
Sure. I still got tucked up in the kitchen, though that cost a buck a piece anyways.
It's all right.
What do you do? Hit a number or something?
Yeah, it's a little bit of a celebration. My brother and I, well, I think he pulled off a big deal today. I think we're going into business together.
Great! That's the best, because, you know, a failing business, you know what I mean.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Because, you know, somebody steals, it's in the family, know what I mean? What?
You noticed I wasn't looking left or right, was I?
No.
And my eyes are closed?
What's the...
Strudel's coming.
No, there's no...
What'd I tell you, Stanley?
Geez, how do you know?
I got radar or something. Stanley, look at that mouth. Those binoculars.
Geez, your life, Mr. Loman.
Wait on her.
Menu, ma'am?
I'm expecting someone, but I'd like...
Well, why don't you bring her... Excuse me, miss. I saw champagne and I'd like you to try my brand. Why don't you bring her a champagne, Stanley?
That's awfully nice of you.
Don't mention it. It's all company money.
That's a charming product to be selling.
Oh, it gets to be like everything else. Selling is selling, you know?
I suppose.
You don't happen to sell, do you?
No, I don't sell.
Oh, well, then would you object to a compliment from a stranger? You ought to be on a magazine cover.
I have been.
See, what'd I tell you, Stanley? She's a cover girl.
Yeah, I could see.
Thank you.
You know what they say in France, don't you? Champagne is the drink of the complexion.
Oh, hiya, Biff.
Hey, kid, sorry I'm late.
Oh, I just got here. Miss...
Forsyth.
It's Forsyth. This is my brother.
Is Dad here?
His name is Biff. You may have heard of him. Great football player.
Oh, really? What team?
Are you familiar with football?
No, I'm afraid not.
Oh, Biff is quarterback of the New York Giants.
Wow, that's nice, isn't it?
Good health.
I'm happy to meet you.
That's my name, Hap. It's actually Harold, but at West Point they called me Happy.
Oh, I see. How do you do?
Isn't Dad coming?
You want her?
Oh, I can never make that.
I remember the time that thought would never come into your head. Where's the old confidence, Biff?
I just saw Oliver.
Wait, I've got to see that old confidence again. Do you want her? She's on call.
Oh, no.
Watch this. Honey, are you busy?
I am. But I can make a call.
Do that, will you, honey? And see if you can bring a friend. Biff and I are going to be here for quite a while. He is one of the greatest football players in the country.
Well, I'm certainly happy to meet you.
Come back soon.
I'll try.
Try, honey.
Try hard.
Isn't that terrible? Beautiful girl like that. That's why I can't get married. There's not a good woman in 1,000.
Look.
I told you she was on call.
Happily, cut it out. I have something I gotta tell you.
Did you see Oliver?
I saw him, all right. Now, there's a couple things I have to tell Dad, and I want you to help me tell them.
What, is he going to back you?
Are you crazy? You're out of your goddamn head, you know that?
Why? What happened?
I did a terrible thing today, Hap. I'm numb all over, I swear.
You mean he wouldn't see you?
I waited 6 hours for him, see? Kept sending my name in, but he wouldn't see me.
Did he remember you?
Finally, around 5 o'clock, he came out. Didn't recognize me or anything. I felt like such an idiot, Hap.
Did you tell him my Florida idea?
He walked out. I saw him for 1 minute. How the hell did I ever get the idea I was a salesman for him? I even believed it myself that he'd been a salesman for him, and then he gave me one look and I realized, Hap, we've been living in a dream for 15 years. I was a shipping clerk.
What'd you do?
Well, he left, see? And the secretary went out. I was all alone in the waiting room. I was so mad I could have torn the walls down. Can't explain it, Hap. Next thing I know, I'm in his office, paneled walls and everything, and I took his fountain pen.
Oh, jeez, did he catch you?
I ran. I ran down all 11 flights. I ran and ran and ran.
That was an awful jump.
Biff, what'd you do that for?
I don't know. Just, I wanted to take something. I don't know. Happy, you gotta help me. I gotta tell Pop.
Are you crazy? What for?
Happy's gotta know I'm not the kind of guy somebody lends that kind of money to. He thinks I've been spiting him all these years, and it's eating him up.
That's just it. You tell him something nice.
I can't.
Say you got a lunch date with Oliver tomorrow.
So what do I do tomorrow?
You leave the house tomorrow. And come back at night. Say Oliver's thinking it over. He thinks it over for a couple of weeks. Gradually it fades away, and nobody's the worse.
But it'll go on forever.
Tad is never so happy as when he's looking forward to something. Oh. Hello, Scout.
Gee, I haven't been here in years.
Sit down, Pop.
Sure.
Have a drink.
Sure, I don't mind.
Let's get a load on.
You look worried.
No, no. Scotch, all around. Make it doubles.
Doubles. Right. Had a couple already, haven't you?
Yeah. Yeah, just a couple.
So, tell me what happened. Everything go all right?
Pal, I had an experience today.
Terrific, Pop.
That's so. Well, what happened?
I'm going to tell you everything from first to last. It's been a strange day. I waited quite a while for him.
Oliver?
Yeah, Oliver. All day, as a matter of cold fact, and a lot of instances, facts about my life came back to me. Who was it, Dad? Whoever said I was a salesman for Bill Oliver?
Well, you were.
No, Dad, I was a shipping clerk.
But you were practically.
Pop, I don't know who said it first, but I was never a salesman for Bill Oliver.
What are you talking
now,
about?
Now, let's hold on to the facts tonight, all right? We're not going to get anywhere bulling around.
All
I
right.
was a shipping clerk.
Now, you listen to me.
Let me finish, all right?
I'm not interested in any stories about the past or any kind of crap of that kind, boys. You understand me? Because the woods are burning. I was fired today.
How could you be?
I was fired, and I'm looking for a little good news to bring your mother. Because that woman has waited, and that woman has suffered, and the gist of it is I haven't got a story left in my head to tell her. So don't give me any lectures about facts or aspects. I'm not interested. Now tell me, did you see Oliver?
Jesus Christ, Dad.
You mean he didn't go up there?
Sure, he went up there.
I did.
Well, what kind of a welcome did he give you?
I saw him. How could they fire you?
Did he give you a warm welcome?
I mean, they won't even let you work on commission?
I'm out. So, he gave you a warm welcome, huh?
Sure, Pop, sure.
Well, it was kind of warm
up. Well, I was wondering if you'd remember you. Imagine, man doesn't see him for 10, 12 years, gives him that kind of a welcome.
Damn right.
Pop, look.
You know why he remembered you, don't you? Because in those days, you impressed him.
Pop, let's talk quietly and get down to the facts tonight,
well,
all right?
It's great news, boys. So, did he see you in the waiting room, or did he take you into his office?
Well, he came in, see?
He's a fine man, you know. Very tough man to see.
Oh, I know.
Is that where you had the drinks?
Yeah. He gave me a couple of... No, no!
He told him my Florida
Don't
idea.
Interrupt. What did he say about the Florida idea?
Dad, will you just give me a minute to explain?
I've been waiting for you to explain since I sat down here. Took you into his office, and what?
Well, I talked. See? And he listened.
Famous for the way he listens, you know. What was his answer?
His answer was... Dad, you're not letting me tell you what I want to tell you.
You didn't see him, did you?
I did see him.
What, you insult him? You insulted him, didn't
you? Christ, you let me out of it. Will you just let me out of it?
What the hell?
No, you had to go and flunk
back. I can't talk to him.
Mrs. Long, what happened?
Shut up and leave me alone.
Beth.
Dad, calm down. Take it easy.
Mrs. Longman.
Now, look, I'm going to tell you what happened, and you're going to listen to me. I waited 6 hours for him.
What the hell are you saying?
Mrs.
Longman.
But he wouldn't see me, so finally he...
Mrs. Longman, Biff flunked math.
No!
Birnbaum flunked him. They won't graduate him.
Not to graduate him. He's got to go to university. Where is he? Biff!
No, he left. He went to Grand Central.
Grand? You mean... He went to Boston?
Is Uncle Willie in Boston?
Oh, maybe Willie can help him. Oh, the poor, poor boy.
So I'm washed up with Oliver, you understand? Are you even listening to me?
Sure. If you hadn't flunked.
Flunked what? What are you talking about?
Don't blame it on me. I didn't flunk math, you did. What pen?
It was awful dumb, Biff. A pen like that
you
is
worth... You stole Oliver's pen?
Dad, I just explained it to you.
You stole Bill Oliver's fountain pen?
I didn't exactly steal it. That's just what I've been explaining to you.
He had it in his hand.
And just then Oliver walked in, so he got nervous and stuck it in his pocket.
My God.
I never intended to do it, Dad.
Standish Arms, good evening.
Not in my room.
Dad, what's the matter?
Ringing Mr. Lohman for you?
Not there.
Dad,
stop it.
Dad, sit down. I'll make good somewhere, all right? Now just sit down.
No. You're no good. You're no good for anything.
I am, Dad. I am. Now, look, I'll find something somewhere else, okay? Just sit down and don't worry about anything. Talk to me, Dad.
Mr. Lohman does not answer. Shall I page him?
No. No, no.
He'll strike something, Pop.
No.
Dad. Dad. Listen to me. I'm telling you something good, all right? Dad. Oliver talked to his partner about the Florida idea, you hear? He talked to his partner, and he came to me, and he said... Dad, he said I'm going to be all right, okay? Dad, he said it was just a question of the amount.
Then you've got it?
It's going to be terrific, Pop.
Then you've got it, haven't you? You've got it! You've got it!
No, Dad. I'm supposed to have lunch with them tomorrow. I'm telling you this so that you know I can still make an impression, and I'll make good somewhere else, okay? But I can't see them tomorrow.
Why not? You simply...
But the pen, Pop.
Tell them it was an oversight. Sure, have lunch tomorrow.
I can't say that.
You were doing a crossword puzzle and accidentally used the pen.
Listen, kid, I took those balls all those years ago. Now I walk in with his fountain pen. That clinches it, don't you see? I can't face him like that. I'll just try elsewhere.
Paging Mr. Lohman!
Don't you want to be anything?
Pop, how can I go back?
You don't want to be anything. Is that it?
Don't take it that way. What? You think it was easy for me to walk in that office after what I'd done to him? A team of horses couldn't have dragged me back to Bill Oliver.
Then why'd you go?
Why did I go? Why did I go? Look at you! Look at what's become of you!
Are you spiting me?
God, don't take it that way, goddammit!
You rotten little house, are you spiting me?
I'm like nothing, can't
Someone's
you see
at the
what
door,
I am?
Willie.
Don't. Hey! You're in a restaurant! Now cut it out, both of you! Oh, hello, girls. Sit down.
I guess we might as well. This is Letta.
Aren't you gonna answer the door, Willie?
Well, hello, miss. Sit down. What do you drink?
Letta might not be able to stay a long time.
I gotta wake up very early tomorrow. I got jury duty. I'm so excited. Have you fellas ever been on a jury?
No, but I've been in front of them. This is my father.
Sit down with us, Pop.
Sit him down, Biff.
Come on, Slugger. Drink us under the table. Come on, to hell with it, pal. Sit down.
Aren't you gonna answer the door, Willie?
The door?
The door?
The door, the washroom door. Where's the door?
Right down there.
Willie, aren't you gonna get up? Get up.
I think it's wonderful you bring your daddy along.
Oh, he isn't really your father.
It's Forsythe. You just seen a prince walk by. A fine, troubled prince. A hardworking, unappreciated prince. A pal, you understand? A good companion, always for his boys.
That's so sweet.
Well, girls, what's the program? We're wasting time. Come on, Biff. Gather around. Where would you like to go?
Why don't you do something for him, Hap?
Me?
Don't you give a damn for him?
What are you talking about?
I sense it. You don't give a good goddamn about him. Look what I found in the cellar, for Christ's sake. How can you bear to let it go on?
Me? Who runs away? Who goes
yeah,
off?
But he doesn't mean anything to you. You can help him. I can't. Don't you see what I'm talking about? Happy's gonna kill himself, don't you know that?
Don't I know it? Me?
Happy, help him. Jesus, help him. Help me. Help me, I can't bear to look at his face.
Where are you going?
Jeez, what's he so mad about?
Come on, girls, we'll catch up with him.
Say, I don't like that temper of his.
He's just a little overstrong, he'll be all right.
Shouldn't you tell your father?
No, that's not my father. He's just a guy. Come on, honey. We're going to paint this town. We'll catch up with Biff and... Stanley! Hey, where's the check? Hey, Stanley!
Could you stop laughing? Could you stop?
Oh, aren't you going to answer the door? He'll wake the whole hotel.
Not expecting anybody.
Why don't you go get yourself another drink, honey, and stop being so damn self-centered?
I'm so lonely.
You ruined me, Willie, you know that? You ruined me. Now whenever you come by the office, I say that you go straight through to the buyers. You ruined me.
Well, it's nice of you to say that.
Gee, you are self-centered. Why so sad? You are the saddest, most self-centeredest person I ever did see. Saw. Oh, come on inside, drummer boy. It's a little to be dressing in the middle of the night. Aren't you going to answer the door?
There's nobody there.
Then tell them to go away.
Not expecting anybody. It's a mistake.
It's getting on my nerves, Willie. There's somebody standing out there, and it's getting on my nerves.
All right, just don't hide in the bathroom, will you? And don't come out. I think there's a law in Massachusetts about it, so do not come out. It could be that new room clerk. He looked very mean, so don't come out. It's a mistake. Biff,
why didn't you answer?
What are you doing in Boston?
Why didn't you answer? I knocked on the door for 5 minutes. I called you on the telephone.
I was in the bathroom and had the door shut. I couldn't hear you. Is something wrong at home?
Dad, I let you down.
What's the matter?
Dad.
Come on, Biffo. Let's go downstairs and get you a multi.
Dad, I flunked math.
Not for the term.
For the term. I haven't got enough credits to graduate.
And Bernard wouldn't give you the answers?
He did. He tried. Even so, I only got a 61.
And Birnbaum wouldn't give you 4 points.
Birnbaum refused, absolutely. I begged him, Pop, but he won't give me those points. You have to go and see him before the school closes, because if he just saw the kind of man you were and you talked to him in your way, I'm sure he'd come through for me. The trouble is, Pop, the class came right before practice, see, so I didn't go enough. Would you talk to him? He'd like you. You know the way you can talk.
You're on, sport. Now go downstairs and tell him I'm checking out.
Good work, Dad. I'm sure he'll change it for you. You see, the reason he hated me so much, Pop, is because one day he was late for class, see? So I went up to the blackboard and I imitated him.
You did? What'd you do?
I crossed my eyes and I spoke with a lisp.
So what did the kids think of it?
They nearly died laughing. The square root of 63... Somebody in there?
It's in the room next door.
Somebody got in your bathroom?
Yeah, they're having a party.
Oh, Willie, can I come in? There's something in the bathroom and it's moving!
Go back now, Willie. Go back.
Oh, but I gotta get my clothes, Willie. I can't just...
This is Miss Frances, Biff. She's a buyer. Buys for J.H. Simmonson. They're painting a room, so I let her take a shower here. Go back, Miss Frances. Go back.
I can't go out naked in the hall, Willie.
Get out of here.
Where are my stockings, Willie? You promised me stockings.
I have no stockings for you here.
You had 2 boxes of size 9 shears for me, and I want them.
Here, for God's sake, will you just get out of here?
Certainly got your nerve, Willie. I just hope there's no one in the hall. That's all I hope. Oh, are you football or baseball?
Football.
Yeah, that's me too. Good night.
Well, best be going then. I want to get to Birnbaum first thing in the morning. All right. Now get my suits. I'll get my valises. What's the matter? She's a buyer. Buys for J.H. Simmons. She sees merchandise in her room. And they're painting. Now you don't imagine. Now listen, pal. She's just a buyer. She sees merchandise in her room, and they have to keep it looking just so. All right. Now get my suits. Now stop crying and do as I say. I gave you an order, Ben. Is that what you do when I give you an order? How dare you cry? You'll understand about things like these when you're older. You mustn't overemphasize a thing like this. I'll see Birnbaum first thing in the morning.
Never mind.
Never mind? He's going to give you those points. I'll see to it.
He wouldn't listen to you.
Oh, he most certainly will listen to me. You need those points for the U of Virginia.
I'm not going there.
Well, then if you don't go, you'll make it up in summer school. You've got all summer to.
Dad.
Oh, my boy.
Dad.
There's nothing to me, dear. I was lonely. I was terribly lonely.
Dad. You gave her mama's stockings.
I gave you an order.
Don't touch me, you liar!
Apologize for that!
You fake, you phony little fake, you fake!
I gave you an order, Biff. Come back here, I'll beat you! Come back here, I'll whip you! I gave you an order! Come on,
Mr. Loman, pick it up. Pick it up. Your boys left. They said they'll see you home.
We were supposed to have dinner together.
Can he make it?
Sure. Sure, I can. Do I look all right?
Sure, I look all right.
Well, here's a dollar.
Oh, your son paid me. It's all right.
No, it's fine. You're a good boy. Here's some more. I don't need it anymore.
Oh, no, you don't have to.
Tell me, is there a seed store in the neighborhood?
Seeds? You like to plant?
Yeah, carrots, peas.
Well, there are harvest stores on 6th Ave, but maybe too late now.
Well, I'd best be getting out of here then. Well, I haven't a thing in the ground. I don't know what I'm going to do. I haven't a thing in the ground.
What you looking at?
What are you doing up? Where's Pop? Is he sleeping?
Where were you?
We met two girls tonight, Mom. Very fine types. Here, we brought you some flowers. Put them in your room, Ma. Now, what'd you do that for? Ma, I want you to have some flowers.
Don't you care whether he lives or dies?
Come upstairs, Biff.
Leave me alone. What do you mean lives or dies, pal? No one's dying around here.
Get out of here! Get out of my sight!
I want to see the boss.
You're not going near him.
Where is he?
You invite him to dinner. He looks forward to it all day, and then you just desert him there. There's no stranger you do that to.
Listen, Mom, when
get
I-
Get out of here!
No, Mom, look.
Did you have to go to women tonight? You and your lousy, rotten whores?
All we did was follow Biff around trying to cheer him up. Boy, what a night you gave me.
Get out of here, both of you. Get your things together. You can stay at his apartment. Pick this stuff up. I'm not your maid anymore. Pick it up, you bum, you! You're a pair of animals. Not one, not another living soul would have had the cruelty to walk out on that man in the restaurant.
Is that what he said?
He didn't have to say anything. He was so humiliated, he nearly limped when he came in.
But, Mom, he had such a great time
Shut
with
up.
Us tonight.
You. You didn't even go to see if he was all right.
Nope. Didn't do a damn thing. How do you like that? Left him babbling in a toilet.
You louse, you!
I hit it on the nose. The scum of the earth, and you're looking at him. I want to see the boss, Mom.
You're not going near him. Get out of this house!
We're going to have an abrupt conversation, him and me.
Will you please leave him alone?
What's he doing out there?
He's planting in the garden.
Now? Oh my God.
Let's see. Eric, 1/4 inch apart. Rose, 1 foot rose. Beets, lettuce, 1 foot rose. What a proposition, huh? Terrific. Because the woman has suffered, man, you hear me? And a man has to add up to something. A man can't go out the way he came in. Now listen, Ben. Remember, it's a $20,000 proposition. Now, Ben, I want you to go through the ins and outs of this thing with me. I've got no one to talk to, Ben, and that woman has suffered. You hear me? What's the proposition? $20,000 on the barrel, man. Gilt edge, guaranteed. You understand?
You don't want to make a fool of yourself, William. They might not honor the policy.
How can they dare refuse? Didn't I work like my entire life like a coolie to pay every premium on the nose? And now they don't pay off? Impossible!
It's called a cowardly thing, William.
Why? Does it take more guts to stand here ringing up a big zero for the rest of my life?
That's a point. And 20,000. That is something one can feel with the hand. It is there.
Ben, that's the whole beauty of it. See, it's shining like a diamond in the dark, hard and rough, that I can pick up with my hand. Not like an appointment. This would not be another damn full appointment, Ben, and it changes all the aspects. Because he thinks I'm nothing, see? So he spites me.
But then that funeral will be massive. They'll come from Maine, Massachusetts, Vermont, New Hampshire, all the old-timers with the strange license plates. That boy will be thunderstruck, Ben, because he never realized I am known. New York, New Jersey, Rhode Island, I am known, Ben. He'll see it in his eyes once and for all. He'll see what I am. He's in for a shock, that boy.
He'll call you a coward.
No, that would be terrible.
Yes, and a damned fool.
No, he mustn't. I won't have that.
We'll hate you, William.
Oh, Ben. How do we get back to all the great times? He used to be so full of laughter and comradeship. The sleigh riding in the winter, the ruddiness in his cheeks, and always some good news coming up. Always some good news coming up ahead. And the Simonizing that little red car. Why can't I give him something and not have him hate me?
Let me think about it. I still have some time. Remarkable proposition, but you need to make sure you're not making a fool of yourself.
Huh? Where the hell are those seats? Can't see a goddamn thing in this yard. They boxed in the whole thing.
I'm saying goodbye to you, Pop. I'm leaving and I'm not riding home anymore.
What about your appointment?
I've got no appointment, Dad.
But he put his arm on your shoulder. You've got no appointment?
Pop, listen to me now. Every time I've left here, it's been a fight that sent me out. Today I realized something about myself and I tried to explain it to you and I think I'm not just not smart enough to explain it, make any sense out of it for you. To hell with whose fault it is or anything like that. Let's just wrap it up, okay? Come on inside, let's tell Mom.
No, I don't want to see her.
Come on.
I don't want to see her. Stop being such a bother, will you?
What do you mean you don't want to see her? You don't want them calling you yellow, is that it?
This isn't your fault, this is me. I'm a bum, now let's go inside.
All right. You had it out. I'm leaving and I'm not riding home anymore.
I think that this is the best way. Because there's no use drawing it out. You'll never get along.
People ask where I am or what I'm doing. You don't know and you don't care. That way it can be off your minds and you can start brightening up again. That settles it, doesn't it? What do you say, Scout? Gonna wish me luck?
Shake his hand.
There's no need to mention the pen at all.
Pop, I've got no appointment.
Put his arm on your shoulder and you've got no appointment.
Listen to me, Dad. You're never gonna see what I am, so what's the point of arguing? If I strike oil, I'll send you a check. Otherwise, forget I'm alive. Shake hands, Dad.
Not my hand.
I was hoping not to go this way.
Well, this is the way you're going. Goodbye.
But you rot hell if you leave this house.
Exactly what is it you want from me?
I want you to know that in the valleys, in the trains, in the mountains, wherever you go, that you cut down your life for spite.
No!
Spite is the word of your doing. When you're down and out, remember what did it. When you're riding somewhere beside the railroad tracks, remember, I know you dare blame it on me.
I'm not blaming it on you.
I won't take the rap for this. You
hear? That's exactly what I'm telling you.
I know you're trying to put a knife in me. Don't act like I don't know.
All right then, phony. Let's lay it on the line, all right?
Biff!
Are you crazy?
Leave it there. Don't move it. What is that?
You know goddamn well what that is.
I never heard of it.
You saw it. The mice didn't move it into the cellar. What's this supposed to do? Make a hero out of you? This supposed to make me feel sorry for you?
Never saw it.
There'll be no pity for you, you hear? No pity.
You hear the spider?
You're going to hear the truth. What you are and what I am.
Don't it.
Now.
We never told the truth for 5 minutes in this house.
We always told the
you
truth.
You picked Blow. Are you assistant buyer? You're one of two assistants to the assistant, aren't you?
I'm practically
You're practically full of it. We all are. And I'm through with it. Now hear this, Willie. This is me.
I know you.
You know why I had no address for 3 months? Because I stole a suit in Kansas City and I was in jail. Stop crying! I'm through with it!
I suppose that's my fault!
I stole myself out of every good job since high school!
And whose fault is that?
And I couldn't get anywhere because you blew me so full of hot air that I couldn't stand taking orders from anybody! That's whose fault it is!
I hear that!
Stop it!
About goddamn time you heard that! I had to be boss big shot in 2 weeks and I'm through with it!
Then hang yourself! For spite, hang yourself!
Nobody's hanging himself, Willie. I ran down 11 flights with a pen in my hand today, and I stopped. You hear this? In the middle of that building, I stopped, and I saw you listening to this. I stopped in the middle of that building, and I saw the sky. I saw the things I love in this world, the work and the food and the time to sit and smoke, and I looked at the pen and I said to myself, what the hell am I grabbing this for? Why am I trying to be something I don't want to be? What am I doing in an office, making a contemptuous begging fool of myself when all I want is out there, waiting for me the minute I say I know who I am? Why can't I say that, Willie?
The door to your life is wide open.
I'm a dime a dozen, and so are you.
You're not a dime a dozen. I'm Willie Loman. And you, you're Biff Loman.
I'm a dollar an hour, Willie. A dollar an hour. I tried 7 states and I couldn't raise it. A buck an hour, you gather my meaning? I am not a leader of men, Willie, and neither are you. You were never anything but a hardworking drummer who landed in an ash can like all the rest of them. I am not bringing home any prizes anymore, and you're going to stop waiting for me to bring them home.
You vengeful, spiteful mutt!
I'm nothing, Pop. Can't you see what I am? There's no spite in it anymore.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Why is he crying?
Let me out of here. Will you take that phony dream and burn it before something happens? Put him to bed.
Biff, he likes me.
He loves you, Willie.
Always did, Pop. Cried to me. Boy, that boy is going to be magnificent.
Yes, outstanding, and with 20,000 behind him.
Now, come to bed, dear. It's all settled now.
Yes, yes, we'll go to sleep. Go to sleep now, Pat.
Yes, and it does take a great kind of man to crack open the jungle.
I'm getting married, Pop. Changing everything. I'm gonna run that department before the year is up. Don't forget it. I'll see you, Mom.
Jungle is dark and full of diamonds, Willie.
Be good. Go on up.
Night, Pop.
Come, dear.
One must go in to fetch a diamond out.
Just let me settle down for a little while. Let me sit alone.
I want you upstairs.
In a few minutes. I couldn't sleep right now. Go on. You look awful tired.
Not like an appointment at all. A diamond is rough and hard to the touch.
Go on now. I'll be right up.
I think that this is the best way.
Sure. It's the only way.
The best thing.
Everything's gonna be. Go on now. I'll be right up.
Come right up.
2 minutes. Love me. Always love me. Ben, he'll worship me for it.
It's dark there, but full of diamonds.
Can you imagine the magnificence with $20,000 in his pocket?
Willie, come up!
Yes. It's coming, dear. It's very smart. You realize that, don't you, sweetheart? Even Ben sees it. Goodbye. Ben, when he gets the mail again, he'll be ahead of Bernard.
A perfect proposition all around.
Did you see how he cried? Oh, Ben, if I could kiss him.
Time, William, time.
I always knew one way that Beth, Biff, and I were going to make it.
The boat. We'll be late.
Now, when you kick off, boy, I want a 70-yard boot. Get right down the field under the ball. And when you hit, hit hard and hit low, because it's important, boy. There's all kinds of important people in the stands. And the first thing you realize... Ben, where do I? Ben, how do I?
Willie, you coming up?
Shh.
Willie? Willie, answer me! Willie? No!
Pop!
Thank you.
It's getting dark, Linda.
Please say, Mom. Come on inside, get some rest. I'll be closing the gate soon.
He had no right to do that. There was no necessity for it. It would have helped him.
Come on inside, Mom. It's almost dark.
Why didn't anybody come?
It was a very nice funeral.
I can't understand. First time in years. We were just about free and clear. He only needed a little salary. He was even finished with a dentist.
No man only needs a little salary.
I can't understand it.
There were a lot of nice days. When he'd come home from a trip, or on Sundays, fixing up the front stoop, filling the garage, putting in the extra bathroom. You know, there was more of him in that front stoop than there was in all the sales he ever made.
Yeah. He was a happy man with a batch of cement.
He was so wonderful with his hands.
He had all the wrong dreams. All wrong.
Don't say that.
The man never knew who he was.
That's an insult.
Nobody. Just blame this man. You don't understand. Now, Willie was a salesman. And for a salesman, there is no rock bottom to the life. Now, he don't put a bolt to a nut. And he don't tell you the law or give you medicine. But he's a man. He's way out there in the blue, and he's riding on a smile and a shoe shine. Oh, and they start not smiling back. Now, boys, that's an earthquake. You get yourself a couple of spots in your hat, and you're finished. So nobody does blame this man. Because a salesman has got to dream, boys. It comes with the territory.
Charlie, the man never knew who he was. Why don't you come with me, Hap?
I'm not licked that easily. I'm staying right in this city, and I'm gonna beat this racket. The Loman brothers.
I know who I am, kid.
All right, boy. I'm gonna show you and everybody else that Willie Loman did not die in vain. He had a good dream. It's the only dream you can have. Come out, number one man. He fought it out here. This is where I'm going to win it for him.
Let's go, Mom.
In a minute. Go on, Charlie. I want to. Just for a minute. I never got the chance to say goodbye. Forgive me, dear, but I can't cry. I don't understand it. I can't cry. It seems to me that you're just on another trip. I keep expecting you. Willie, why did you do it? I search and search and I search. And I can't understand it. Willie, I made the last payment on the house today. Today. Dear. And there'll be nobody home.
We're free. And clear. We're free. We're free. We're free.